Welcome back. You are with India Today. Let's turn to the other big story on the news today. The Sushant Singh Rajput case, where the grilling continued today of Riya Chakraborty and this time her parents as well. But India Today has learned from CBI sources that the agency is now squarely looking at suicide and that there is no evidence that has emerged as of now of any indication of foul play or murder in the actor's death. Take a look at this story.
Over 75 days after Sushant Singh Rajput died in his Bandra flat, the CBI is leaning towards the suicide theory. Three CBI officers who are part of the probe team have separately confirmed to India Today that so far they've not found any evidence to suggest the Bollywood star was murdered. The investigation still remains open though. CBI officers are now focusing on the suicide angle and are examining if a case can be made out for abetment to suicide. The elaborate reconstruction at the scene of death by the CBI's forensics team had earlier shown that suicide was possible.
The next key element in the probe is going to be the report which will be submitted by the AIIMS doctor on the autopsy and visceral report of late actor Sushant Singh Rajput.
The CBI on Tuesday questioned Riya Chakraborty's parents for the first time. They were questioned on a range of topics, including how many times they had met Sushant Singh Rajput and if Riya had discussed Sushant's mental health issues with them. Riya, who has been interrogated for over 35 hours over 4 days, was not called on Tuesday. But her brother Shawik was questioned for the sixth consecutive day. Meanwhile, the investigation into Riya's possible drug link too has widened. Goa-based hotelier Gaurav Arya, whose WhatsApp chats with Riya have surfaced, was grilled by the Enforcement Directorate for a second time. Sources say Arya has denied the allegations. They say he claims Riya spoke to him casually about drugs, but he didn't entertain her.
Gaurav Arya's lawyer Manu Sharma has claimed that all the allegations leveled against him are baseless and they would soon release a statement regarding the same. Also, Narcotics Control Bureau has started their crackdown and two persons have been detained by Narcotics Control Bureau who were dealing in doobies which were found in WhatsApp chats of Riya Chakraborty with others. There are sources from NCB who are telling us that the two detainees who are being interrogated by Narcotics Control Bureau could be probed for their links with Riya and her brother Shawik Chakraborty. With Arvind Oja and camera person Kiran Sapkal, this is Divyesh Singh in Mumbai for India Today.
And joining me now is a very special guest, former DG, former Mumbai Police Commissioner, one of the country's most respected police officers, Julio Ribeiro, joins me because I'm told, Mr. Ribeiro, that you are disappointed, dare I say even angry, at the manner in which the Mumbai police has been targeted in the Sushant Singh Rajput case. You seem to believe, I'm told, that this is not the way the police should be put under pressure.
You know, Rajdeep, the point is much further than that. It is not only the Mumbai police which is being put under pressure, but the fact that if you accept this principle that a case can be registered in some other state or even at some other police station, say in Mumbai, and two parallel inquiries are made, it is going to turn into a huge problem. And people from other states also may jump in because they are very happy with the publicity you get from investigating a case like this where people are all very eager to know what has happened. But I think that it is not on. And I'm surprised that the Supreme Court has given it to the CBI. Well, it is their privilege to do so. They can do it. Mm-hmm. But I think that the Mumbai police was actually investigating it on the proper lines. But if there is something very funny happened there or somebody has appropriated some money or diverted funds, then that's a different matter. But here the enforcement director had already started their own inquiries because they can. If there is some money laundering involved, well, they are entitled to open that case. But basically, they are more interested in the political part of this inquiry and not on the facts of the case. This is what I can gather.
But do you believe that, therefore, this is a case of suicide, as is being suggested? Because now there are fresh theories that have from time to time cropped up in this case. Do you believe this is a case where now we've got the CBI, the ED, the Narcotics Control Bureau, all looking at this particular case? So obviously there will be naturally a lot of focus on this case. Do you believe that that focus is should not be there? Are you saying that the Mumbai police was doing a good job? Do you really believe that?
Look, what are the facts of the case? The actor was found hanging from a ceiling, from a fan in his bedroom. The bedroom was locked from inside. Can anyone disprove that it was locked from inside? For 4.5 hours, a locksmith was trying to break open that lock. He was not able to do it. And then they had to use some special methods. I don't know what they did. But they opened the lock from outside, and there was only the body. Now, unless there is some, some extraterrestrial being who has got into how can it even think about anything except suicide? Now, if a man commits suicide, the only other way of charging someone for it is to say that he abetted to help in committing suicide. Now, abetment has to be proved, and abetment does not mean just getting out of a love affair or something like that. It must be much deeper, which he had no other alternative but to commit suicide. So his state of mind, various things have to be investigated, which was being done. But I don't see any reason why so much
Mr. Ribeiro?
Agencies have been put on the case.
Are you giving a clean chit to the Mumbai police? Are you saying that you don't believe the accusation that the Mumbai police was acting under pressure? Because these accusations have been made repeatedly. Do you not believe that the Mumbai police could be acting under pressure?
No, that I'm not sure. I mean, not acting under pressure. All police forces today are under pressure from the people who are ruling, the ruling party. So that is not improbable or impossible. I don't say that. But I only go by the facts of the case. If you are going to try to make it into a murder, I don't see how you can do that. And number two is to prove that somebody is responsible for the person's death. As far as I know, that girl was not in the house at that time. She had already left some 3 or 4 days ago when the sister of the actor had come to live there. I feel that the sister was there at the time he died. So I don't know what we are talking about.
Let me ask you in conclusion, Mr. Ribeiro, you of course were a police officer in the pre-24/7 television news media age. Are you worried at the manner in which a media trial is being carried out, in a manner in which someone is presumed guilty and then asked to prove their innocence? Will this trouble policing? Even your constables are being harangued at times. They are being jostled, pushed by TV cameras. Does all of this trouble you? Pizza delivery boys are targeted.
I'm the only person I'm sorry for is that girl. I mean, I don't know whether she has done any taken some money out of his account. I could not be sure about that. That can be investigated, and the ED is doing that. But why are they? They are just trying to target her, according to me, just to sort of take it out on our young leader, the Shiv Sena leader. So that is what is being attempted, because then the fact that the Shiv Sena played a little bit of a mischief in during the formation of the government and dumped.
What would your message be to the television channels, which seem to have already decided who is guilty? What would you tell the media today?
I must make a confession here that I have not been watching the television. I'm staying with my daughter, and that's why I have not been following the television at all. I read the newspapers every morning, and that's where I get the information from. So about the television channels, I'm not sure. I read in the papers that there was some allegation that they are making it a media trial, but that happened also in other cases. They keep doing this media trial, which is really disgusting, right, according to me. I think these people who are right in the forefront, yes, of the trial should also be brought to the court as to give evidence. That will stop all this nonsense.
Strong words from you, Mr. Ribeiro.
They should be summoned
strong, powerful
to the
words.
Court
I hope someone there
they are
is
making,
listening.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for joining me this evening.
Thank you,
I
Mr. Rajdeep.
The voice of Julio Ribeiro resonates loud and clear. Loud and clear. It is disgusting, says the former top cop of this country, if media channels are going to pronounce guilt in TV studios. If they have evidence, they should bring it before court. If not, they should stop making baseless allegations. It is disgusting, as he puts it. Well, food for thought.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.